So I need to make a confession.
What is it, son?
Now, I don't regularly go to church, but I have done something horrible.
What are you doing?
I'm dead. I'd like to get my sins off my chest.
No, I'm not Catholic, but isn't that something you're supposed to do before you die?
Well, given the circumstances, it's better late than never.
No, 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 don't do it!
Now.
I know, you don't want to go there. It's only going to make this place worse.
Excuse me one moment, son. This town is bothering me.
What the hell is our problem?
Something must be troubling her.
Probably withholding more information from us. She obviously knows more about this place.
Why must everyone be a hostile witness to you?
How old do you think she is?
Early 20s, I'd say.
Her parents. No one should have to see their kids die before them.
What? I can't just leave my car there, stuck in the mud like that.
But if I don't eat, my father will kill me. And then he'll kill you.
How's a tow truck going to get down here in this weather? I should be waiting with my car.
Once you take me home, you can go back. And I'm sorry that my parents have a stricter curfew than yours. At least it's not raining here.
They don't deserve to be here this young.
They are here.
Should we tell them where your men is?
They may be better off not knowing.
Are you serious? They have every right to know as much as we do.
She won't say much about this place, but I think I've gotten her to calm down. I see we have new arrivals.
Yeah. We're debating whether or not to share our dignity with them.
They will learn when the time is right.
Do you get the feeling everyone's watching us, or am I just being paranoid?
I think they are watching us. Excuse me, could you tell us which way this train goes? Like, when does it come?
Is there something we can help you with here?
No, I'm just trying to get my girlfriend home.
Yes, sister. My boyfriend and I, we got in a little car trouble. You know, embarrassing story, really, but I need to get home soon. Do you know when the train gets to... What's the closest station to my house?
I don't know if there is one.
There has to be one. Why else would we have come down here?
Now that I think about it, have we ever been on this subway before? Is there even a station in our town, or anywhere near us in Indiana?
You have a point. Excuse me, could you tell us which way this train goes?
Which way? Which way?
Well, now that's an enigmatic inquiry.
We are going to get on the next train without knowing where it's going?
Okay, what do you mean you don't know where it's going?
It's just a little bit complicated.
A little bit complicated? That train is our only way out of here, and we don't even know which way it goes.
Our only way out?
Well, as I see it, the theology states there are only two places this train can go. some of the adults around here.
Thanks, I guess.
So, if we're, you know, then is everyone else here too?
Probably. So, what happens next?
Excuse me?
The train. Which way is it going? Up or down?
Well, we haven't determined that yet. How ironic. When I assigned Dante's Divine Comedy to my students last semester, I didn't think I'd soon be experiencing it.
There's not a single clue anywhere here, not on any of the walls. How the hell are we supposed to know anything?
And that's what she's not telling us. You know which way the train goes.
No!
You're holding information again! You know which way the train is going. That's why you haven't gotten on board yet.
Said I came across an error of around $25,000 in the company's favor. I tried to tell my supervisor, but he brushed me off and didn't want to hear it. So, if the company didn't want to acknowledge its existence, well, you see my oldest daughter, she starts college in a year, and my tuition being what it is.
You embezzled it?
I wired it to my bank account, and it worked. A few days went by, no one said anything.
Thou shalt not steal! Even I know that's a commandment!
says it's going to happen, so it must be true. We have a nun here.
We also have a lawyer.
Looks like someone's going to hell!
It's a 50-50 chance.
What is your problem with me?
My wife recently filed for divorce.
Plain stereotyping! I'm not a divorce attorney, I'm a prosecutor!
You know what? That explains why you
seriously do not know which way it goes.
We're a bunch of old dead folks who might be good or bad. Same as you, huh?
Damn it. They don't know what you're supposed to do.
Hi, sister. They'd love to know you're over here. We're firefighter from Omaha. Died in a fire to save two kids and a family dog.
That's good.
Buddy, she doesn't on his income tax. We also have a lawyer. Says he can do charity, but it seems too sleazy.
Our lawyer is opinionated, but no way sleazy.
That almost sounded like a compliment.
He bragged about people he saved from jail time, but they did seem like high class citizens, if you kind of catch my drift on that.
Defense attorney?
Yeah.
Let me talk to him. Then I'll tell you which side's going to hell.
Wait, that's it. You lost a big case to a defense attorney.
I was trying. A drug dealer. He was selling the kids. He was clearly guilty. I'm sure the judge knew it. I would have met the jury in their minds. But his lawyer blew holes in all of my evidence. Inadmissible. Even made my best witness look unreliable on the stand. He got the jury to doubt the legality of the arrest warrant. And a reasonable doubt to acquit.
Couldn't you appeal or arrest them on a separate charge or something? We do it all the time on TV.
I've been
unit, how? We are no closer than when I first got here.
Why do you think you're bound for hell?
I ran away from home when I was 16 because my parents wouldn't let me date this older guy. Said he was bad news. But I didn't listen, so I dropped out of school and left with him. It was such a dumb move. We both got jobs at a burger joint to help pay rent, and almost a year later, I thought I had gotten pregnant. So when I tried to tell him, he hit me and left, taking all the money we had. And he even told my boss that I had been stealing from the registers when it was him doing it. So I was fired. I had no job, no money, and nowhere to go.
Couldn't you go back home?
I wanted to, but I was young and stupid. I didn't think my parents would want to see me again. I said some pretty nasty things to them, and I thought I couldn't go back. I lived on the streets for a couple years. I did so many bad things to get food, money, and cigarettes. I was gonna give it up after this one. Give it all up and straighten out my messed up life. And then I was here. I don't know how I died. Exposure, accident, who knows? What's worse is, I don't think my parents know that I'm dead. And they certainly don't know I'm sorry for what I did to them.
When was all of this?
2, maybe 3 years ago.
You've been here that long?
It's hard to tell in this awful place, but it feels like longer. And it's always the same thing over and over. And I'm tired of reliving my life to every new person that comes through here.
There's a way you can break that cycle, dear. Come on, train with us.
I told you I won't. I don't deserve to go to heaven, and I'm not going to hell.
When I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me.
What if she's right? What if this is the train to hell?
Well, we don't know that yet.
And we sure don't.
I don't necessarily think I should be going to heaven either. What makes you say that?
How come it wasn't your fault? That's not what you said before, was it, Indra? think that's